girl in the pastry shop with the net in her hair is making a cannoli for you to take on your hiking trip in the woods with your bros that you've known since second grade. And your main kind of dragons are ruffians and be called upon to employ your testosterone in a battle for supremacy and access to females glued to the TV. And even if you are victorious, you may receive many cuts, bruises, and scrapes, and you will require band-aids and antiseptic ointments and tender loving kisses on your stab wounds. And when you come home, she will be there waiting for you with a fire in her eyes and a big fat cannoli to shove in your mouth. And that's why I thank God for girls. Holidays in Christie, from Tennessee to LA. Thank God for girls. On your reckoning day, she isn't mine. I think about her all the day and all the night. It's enough to know that she's alive. She says I give a sweaty palm. She almost had a heart attack. The truth is that I'm just as scared. I don't know how to act. I wish that I could get to know her better, but meeting up in real life will cause illusion to shadow her. I call the name into all the trees, sing a song down on one knee, looking at the underwear page of this year's catalog like when I was 14. Centrifuge machine, mixed it with cardamom and cloves, microwaved it on the popcorn setting while Adam was like, that really hurts. So pissed at God, and he started lighting mighty forest fire, stealing osprey eggs, messing with the bees who were trying to pollinate the echinacea, until God said, I'ma smite you with loneliness and break your heart in two. And Adam wept and wailed, tearing out his hair, falling on his knees, looked to the sky and said, thank God.